Hello and welcome to AA's Art Channel. My name is Elk-Jan Wiersma, and today we have kind of a special video. Because first of all, this is will be my 100th upload on my video on my channel. And I found it very nice, because when I started my channel, I never thought that I would make so many videos and tutorials. But I ended up liking them more and more, and I'm getting quite a lot of nice responses to them. Which I really like, obviously, and yeah, it's just a nice side factor. Besides making the artwork, it's just a little bit extra. And also, what really drives me in making these tutorials is this is just how I learned as well. So I saw other people the tutorials from other people, from other artists, sharing their tips and techniques, and that is how I learned drawing and painting. I had a few lessons when I started out, but only five, so they are, it means basically nothing, a few lessons just to try it, but it was not my style. And so I ended up searching on the internet, and I came across YouTube, and especially on Lisa from Lockery Fine Art. I really, really love her artwork and her techniques, and I think she really explains them very well. So that's how I started making more and more art. And of course, I really like it, but I liked it so much more because I found something that was suitable for me, that I liked, that I understood, and that something that I could work from. So that's how I ended up making more and more art. Besides my daily job, I really make quite a lot of art, I think. I spend a lot of hours here in my studio, and just because I like it. And I think it is, for me, it's better than only watching TV or sitting after on your computer and that kind of stuff. So I think it's very beneficial, and especially because it's a sort of therapy as well for me. So I really enjoy it, and I think I'm gonna make more tutorials, maybe another 100, I don't know, but I as far as I as it looks now, I think I will get there, because I really like it. So that said and done, that makes it a little bit special, especially for me, and I hope for you as well, of course. And also, I thought it would be nice to make a video about sharing tips. Because I thought it would be very suitable. So I'm not completely gonna talk about this piece yet. It's an Inktanks project. Maybe you know, have seen it on my Instagram, but this will be up next week, I hope. But I'm going to share some very nice tips, I think. I came across while I was working, and so therefore, like I said, that's the way how I learned making art, and then that's also the big inspiration for me to make these tutorials. So therefore, I thought it would be nice to do a video about five tips on how to improve making artwork in Inktanks. At least that's the plan. So, I have quite a long intro already, so I'm now going to dive in those tips. And here is the first one. The first one will be about the watercolor palettes. And I found this idea on Facebook quite some years ago, but it works really well, and I'm going to show you why it works really well for me now. So here we do have the box of the inking blocks. Normally it kind of looks like this, and you may notice that I have broken off some pieces of the blocks. I will see you let you see why I did that, but this is basically what you get when you buy the full set of the blocks. And you have an area here where you can mix your colors, but I find it kind of annoying to only use the brush, put it in here, and that takes a lot of time. So then I thought I'm gonna grab out the blocks, hold them over here, get some water on it. But in the end, it was a lot of trouble, a lot of work, so I thought this is taking too much time. I have to come up with a better plan. So I came up with these watercolors palettes. And you can get these things out. I have to see. Yeah, where am I here? You can get them out. And so you can grab a piece of your block and get a piece off of that and then put it in here. And the nicest thing is, you can see it a bit, but if you have some leftovers, they will stay in this container, these little containers, so we can re-wet them quite easily and use them again. So therefore, these pellets, watercolor pellets, I found very, very useful. And I have to admit, at first when I had to break those blocks into little pieces, I thought, well, I don't know, and I really like the blocks, but yeah, I'm so happy I did it. This saves so much time. I can now easily grab some colors, put them on my separate pellets, and it's, like I said, it's very easy, because the leftovers are still usable. You don't lose as much ink tints as I did with these kind of pellets, these kinds of areas where you can put in the ink. Because for some paintings, I have to mix up quite a lot of different colors. So I have, 6 of these boxes are not enough to mix all the colors. So therefore, I really like these pellets, these watercolor pellets. So that's the first one, and it saves me so much time working like this, because I don't have to grab the sticks out of the box and like explained in the video. And you can imagine on a piece of artwork like this one, where I have a lot of layers in, it would cost me a lot of more time to mix in those colors. So therefore, I'm really happy with those watercolor palettes. I have my tips wrote down, so that's why I'm looking down now, but I'm going to the second one. And it's also about palettes, because this is another type of palette which is very useful, for especially for the ink things, if you ask me. Here it is. So over to the actual palette that I use for my ink things. We had a little talk about these kinds. It's basically the same situation, because I have these plastic palettes. I have 3 of them. I just grabbed one. And as you can see, I mix quite a lot of different colors here. There's a lot of room to do that. But I had enough for my flamingo, so that's why I came up with 3 of those little ones, so I can switch. But this is very useful, because this color is now dry. All the colors are now dry. But if I grab some water, it's very easy to reactivate them, as you can see. And you see that? Now I'm already ready to paint again. Use this color. I can grab a bit of this color, mix it in with this one, and it goes very, very quickly.
We are now at the third tip. And actually, it's about a nail file. And while I was recording it, I couldn't remember the name, but it's I'm talking about a nail file. And I'm using them to sharpen up the points of my pencils. I actually copied kind of this trick, because it's the same trick that I use in my pastel work. So you may see me use it there, but it works for the for every pencil, so also for the pencils for the ink tints. And I'm going to demonstrate you now why I'm and how I'm using these nail files.
So here we have the pencil with a very thick and short and a bit dull point on it, so it's a bit harder to make fine lines. Can make some finer lines, but therefore I like I said, to use this thing and just going over it like this. I'm not turning the pencil, I'm just now turning the pencil and go up and down. And while I'm making that movement, I'm not turning the pencil. So that makes a quite sharper point than I had before. So it's easier to make those teeny tiny fine lines. As you can see, a lot more control in comparison to this line and these very thin and fine lines. So that's how I make those teeny tiny details with the pencils.
And what I did forget to mention about the nail files, they are very cheap. For example, I bought about 10 of them on AliExpress, and they were about 1 euro or something. So they are very cheap but very handy, and they will last a lifetime, I think. So that's very nice, of course. I like cheap art materials if they work, of course. So that's it and done. Now we're going to tip number 4. And that is how I make these smooth feathers. I don't know exactly how to call them. Those are feathers, but these are a little bit more standing out. And these ones are laying very flat. They are like almost like a blanket of feathers. And our coat of feathers, but it can be quite hard to make them, especially for me. I'm talking for myself, of course, or about myself. I found it quite hard because you see some detail in there, but it's not very strong. It's not like you see those lines in the feathers here. I will come up close if you not can see it good enough. But these kind of feathers, I found a quite a nice tip, I think, to make them kind of easy.
So I start out using the pencils and slowly building up my details. And maybe if you noticed it, when you use the pencils of the inktint and you use water, they show up very, very well, very bright colors you get. So therefore, I'm slowly building up, barely touching the pencil with on the paper, so I get a minimum of that inktings on there.
So what I do, and you can see my white block here, it's a little bit dirty, but it doesn't matter. If you get enough of these inktings, it will not show up. But I just grab a damp brush, get it over this block, and then I'm going to apply it on the paper, and I will demonstrate it now.
So I have that brush loaded with the white inks from the blocks, and I'm slowly building up the layers over the details that I drew in with a pencil. And this way I get a very lighter color. I don't get that intense color which I would get if I only used water. And I really like this. The white inktank shows up very well, but it's very easy to cover it with glazes of color. And that is how I found it quite easier to make this slow, not that strong transitions between the feathers for these kind of areas.
So, and the last tip already is number 5. It's not something that I personally discovered. You see it quite a lot, or I see it quite a lot by different artists who use it. But it's called Friskit, or drawing gum. My bottle says drawing gum. But I only knew it from a bottle. When you take a pencil, a brush, and you pick it up and you apply it with that brush on your paper. But then I saw, I think it was Sheldine, she had also this Friskit, but she had it in a bottle with a very, very fine tip. And I thought that would be very handy for those little teeny tiny marks that I like to make where the feathers should go. So therefore I thought, yeah, I need to include this one because it's very, very handy. And I think it will do as well for watercolors. Maybe for some acrylic paints, if you like to cover some little teeny tiny details up, but also it works very, very great in inktings. So here is tip number 5. And this bottle is so handy to get in those little details, for example, around those little feathers around his neck, cover up with Friskit, and actually it's called drawing gum. On this bottle, but let me show you why I think this is so very useful. And I have to get a lid off, there it goes. because of the tip of this one, it comes with a sort of needle inside the lid. I hope you can see it. I hope my camera picks it up. It's the thickness of a needle, I think you can see it now. And it goes in this one. It's also a sort of needle on top of this bottle. And this lid is need to be closed. But this is how I just squeeze a little bit in the any bottle. And then I'm going to make, I did make those little teeny tiny lines. And I get a really nice cover on my paper. I do this flat. I now have this on my easel, so I can show it you a little bit better on camera. But I do this flat because it's thinner than a normal Friskit, or I call it normal Friskit that we use with when you use a brush to get it onto the paper. So it's a little bit thinner, but otherwise it wouldn't go through that needle, of course. But it's very, very handy to cover up little areas where you want little details to stay, to let the paper be white so you can cover them later on. Otherwise, I would have very thick lines here, because otherwise I couldn't get the feathers in. And now, and you can see, oh, I squeeze a little bit of the bottle, but it's very thin, so it comes out very easily. But that's very useful, like I said, to make those little details. So that were my 5 tips, and I think they are very useful. At least I like to use them, of course. If you not like them, I'm sorry for that, of course, but I hope it will inspire you then to improve or to make some other tips based on these kinds. Or I really like to make things my own. I not always copy exactly what another person does, but it inspires me, and that is the most important part of this video. And also, before I forget, I really like to take this opportunity to wish you all the very best for 2020. I hope it will be a wonderful, great year for you guys, and I hope that we see one another quite a lot at least on my channel. Thank you for sticking around with me, and I am going to try to upload many artworks. And if you like this tutorial, I can make more of these kinds of tutorials. So therefore, please let me know in the video in the comment section below. If you don't already have, please subscribe to my channel. That would be really helpful for me. And if you do, please hit that bell button next to it, because then you will get a notification if I uploading a new tutorial. For now, that's it and done. Thank you for watching, and I hope to see you at one of my next tutorials. Bye bye.